What's good, YouTube? Today we have a trading card game match on Pokemon TCG Online against Alka. And I'm actually debuting my Hydro Ball. No. Yeah, Hydro Ball deck. That's the one. Unfortunately, I don't actually manage to draw any basic cards on the first turn. And this match was considerably long, so I did have to speed it up. And of course, I get at least one basic card this turn around. So basically what I'm going to do is obviously wait until it's my turn. He's going to shove a water energy onto his Horsea and then Pont out into a new hand. Now I'm going to draw, go for Reshiram onto my bench, use Pecom to get rid of my Pignite, and then get a Zweilous. Is it Zweilous? Yes, Zweilous in return. Obviously, I can't evolve him just yet, so I'm just going to attack. And, of course, that's going to do a little bit, and he's going to be able to play a Jigglypuff, and then put another energy onto Horsea, and then attack me for, I believe it's just 20 damage, something like that, or 10, whatever. Oh, no, he actually does 40. Never mind, I misread that. So I'm going to be able to evolve my Zweilous, and I'm going to Pecom out for a Clefairy, just in case I do need to kind of get a new hand, and I'm then going to be able to just use a fire energy onto Zweilous and get a fresh hand. So now I believe I just go for a Pecom, get rid of my Ember, and then I can go back into a Zekrom, play that on the bench, which means that now I've got a Reshiram and a Zekrom, just in case I do actually want to get rid of any water types or even grass types, which is what his deck is. And I actually flip a couple of coins for double hit, and I only get one of the heads, so Horsea, I'm afraid, isn't actually going to get KO'd this turn, which is a shame. Which also means he has to play his Chikorita? Yeah. And then he can attack with Horsea, do 20 damage, doesn't actually get to KO me, which is brilliant for me. And I'm going to put a fire energy on and retreat out my Zweilous, and then I believe I send in my Clefairy, just so I can use its ability just in case I do need it to get a new hand. I don't actually like need it at first because I've got a Professor Oak's new theory, but I do actually go for it just to refresh my hand and get a new start. Unfortunately, I don't really get anything decent. Best thing I can use at the moment is, I'm guessing, a Fisherman, maybe? Revive might come in handy if my Hydreigon gets KO'd, because he has to evolve his Horsea. Tough call, really. But it's all good, I guess. As long as he doesn't get Kingdra out for now, I shouldn't be too bothered. Muddy Water isn't going to do a great deal of damage to my Hydreigon, which is brilliant. It's only going to do 10. And since Hydreigon's got 150 HP, I really don't have to start worrying about anything until I see a... God damn it, what the hell is it called? A Kingdra. There you go. I'm trying to do this all in one take, because I don't really have time to make cuts in that at the moment. And unfortunately, he does evolve a Kingdra, despite the fact that I've not been able to wake up my Clefairy, and all I really got was a fire energy that I could shove onto Reshiram. So he's going to do a bit of damage to my Hydreigon. I'm going to go for a Fisherman, get a couple of energies back, and shove those onto my Zekrom. Make sure I start setting up my Zekrom so that when he hits me, I can then hit him back a little bit harder, which is brilliant for me, of course. So he's going to use Professor Elm's new theory, get a, I believe it was a Grottle. And then, of course, he's going to equip his Grass Energy, shove that onto, I believe it was Jigglypuff. I could be wrong. But either way, it doesn't particularly matter too much. He's not quite able to carry my Hydreigon just yet. He's almost able to, but at the same time, it doesn't particularly matter all too much now. And just by re-looking through this video, I realized that I had a friggin' double colourless energy, which would have been absolutely brilliant, but I guess I didn't really think to use it. Which is a shame, I guess. But at the end of the day, Hydreigon's gonna get KO'd, so it's not too bad, but it does give Alka the lead. And it just means that I can refresh for a new hand, and of course, at some point, if I really need to, I can switch out my Zekrom, which means that he can basically kick some real ass. I do get a Dino in this one, which is brilliant, because that means if I get a PCOM, or Pokemon Communication, I can swap out either my Pignite or my Zweilous, and shove out another Hydreigon. The only problem is, I don't actually have any double colorless in my hand at the moment. Is a shame, but doesn't really matter all too much because I've got plenty of time to kind of set up this one. And I've actually sped this up to double time, which is a bit annoying, but again, doesn't really matter too much. So Kingdra goes for an attack on my Reshiram, which means that basically he's just trying to sort make it so that I can't use my Zekrom, which is probably one of his biggest weaknesses. But I do get a PCOM or a Pokemon Communication, which means that I can PCOM out my Zweilous, get in a Hydreigon, shove my Hydreigon onto the bench with Rare Candy, and then hopefully next turn Cleffa wakes up, I can shove out either Reshiram or Zekrom. It doesn't really matter, either one. I'd probably go for Reshiram at this point. But unfortunately, he actually wakes up one turn too soon, so I'm like, oh god, that's bad. You know, that's really bad, because he can easily get another prize card. But he actually goes for a Water Hour on Dino, which surprised me a little bit. But again, at the end of the day, it doesn't really matter too much. I'm going to evolve my Dino into Hydreigon, and I believe I just equip a energy onto Reshiram, and then switch out into my Reshiram and go for a Blue Flare, which is absolutely brilliant because that will KO Kingdra. Unfortunately, I only have the one energy now, which is a little bit of a pain for saying I have nothing to switch out my Reshiram into my Cleffa for. So, all Cleffa, or not Cleffa, sorry, he sends in Jigglypuff, uses Hypnoblast, and I do wake up first turn, but I get an Emboar. Not very good for me. So all I can do is end my turn and get Hypnoblasted again, which means I'm going to be put to sleep. And I have to admit, sleep in this match is a definite theme, common occurrence if you wish, and I hate the hell out of sleep, you know, especially with this one. I just never seem to wake up when I want to. So, of course, Reshiram's going to sleep again. It's got 70 damage on now. I'm going to be able to go for a Pokemon Collector, get some basics. And I can get my Vulpix going, which will be brilliant, which means I can evolve my Vulpix into Ninetales on the next turn, and then as soon as I get a Fire Energy, I can use Ninetales' ability to draw, I think it's 3 cards. But yeah, unfortunately I'm going to get put to sleep by Hypnoblast, and I'm not going to wake up this turn, so I can evolve my Vulpix into Ninetales, use its ability to trade out a Fire Energy, draw 3 cards. I get Pokemon Collector, don't really need that right now, but I can evolve my Dino into Zweilous, and then get another kind of evolution with Professor Elm's, I believe it's New Theory. But all I can really get is an Emboar, which is really annoying because it means that my other Hydreigon is actually prized, and I really should have checked that earlier on in the game, but it doesn't really matter all too much. So, as you can see, I'm just like looking through my discard pile, and there is only one Hydreigon in there. I just wanted to check that. And he plays another Horsey, which means for a guess that he's going to try and get out another Kingdra if he has one. And he actually goes for another Hypnoblast, and of course I wake up then. And guess what? I've got no energies. So, probably not the best trade-off. But at the end of the day, nothing to worry about too much. I still have my Zekrom, and I still have my Zweilous and Hydreigon. None of them are really set up, but I still have them. It's better than nothing at the end of the day. And my Reshiram is obviously going to get knocked out thanks to lots and lots of sleeping. So I think he's really feeling happy for himself at this point. So I'm going to send in my Cleffer, and I'm actually going to shove a energy onto my Hydreigon, and I figure, might as well refresh my hand. So I refresh my hand, get several more energies, which is brilliant. The only thing is, I got a friggin', I don't even want to say it, I got a Ember, but no Tepig, and that pees me off so much. I traded out an Ember and a Tepig, and really I should have probably ever like put one down at least, but I don't know. So anyway, Hypnoblast is going to do 20 damage, and I really want to kind of switch out right now. Why I don't go out to... Oh no, sorry, I'm getting ahead of myself. I draw some new cards, and I actually get a... Is that double colours? Yeah, it is. And I believe I actually go for a switch out. Yeah, I switch out, or I retreat with my... Cleffer, and I go into my Zekrom, and then I can do a little bit of damage to Jigglypuff, and of course on the next turn he's going to turn around and use his attack and of course put me to sleep, which is kind of annoying. He's also played a Turtwig and evolved his Chikorita into Bayleaf, and his Horsey into Seedra. Sorry, I'm starting to get quite tired. But as we're waiting, as you can see, I've got a double colorless energy, which will set up my Hydreigon fully. But as I said, the only problem is my Zekrom is now asleep, and he doesn't want to wake up. So I figure, right, I'm going to have to attach a double colorless to my Hydreigon, and somehow I'm also going to get rid of a fire energy so I can draw three cards. And I suppose at this point my hand is alright. You know, I can use little junk arm if needs be, which I do actually end up doing. I believe I discard a Vulpix and an Ember. And then, of course, I can pick up more or less any trainer I want, you know, Pecom, or doesn't really matter which I get. Pretty much every single one of them is useful at this point. So I'm going to PCOM my Ember for a Tepig. Was it Ember? That didn't seem right. Oh, never mind. And then I can use Interviewer's Questions, get the three energies that I believe are left in my deck, actually. Which is a tad bit worrying. And I don't know whether you could call this wasting cards or anything, but when I actually use the Rare Candy to evolve my Tepig into an Ember, I will start shoving like fire energies on it, and I also use up my last double colorless, which in a way is a tad bit of a pain. You know, you will understand why in a minute, but anyway, at the end of the day, Rare Candy, Ember, Zekrom's still asleep, and to be honest, like, it's going to be that way for a long while. You know, he stays asleep a lot, and he is quite the problem. I struggle to get him awake, and I don't know whether you could say, like, that's one of the reasons why I find Jigglypuff so annoying, but you get the idea at the end of the day. Of course, I can't actually retreat any of my Pokemon right now. I can't do anything other than really maybe check for more energy should I need them. As you can see, my deck is actually quite low at the moment, which is a bit of a problem for me, I guess. But again, in the normal kind of game, I would have lost this match way before the end of this video, but I don't know, I think it's the Wi-Fi, it's like buggy on this kind of thing, because like the time is able to run over, and Don't get me wrong, I don't know if this is just me, but I can't deck out. Don't ask me why, I just can't. Whereas normally, as you can see, I've only got 3 cards left, but whereas normally, I would be forced to kind of deck out. So anyway, things are kind of heating up here. He's actually got his Meganium out, which is bad for me, and my Zekrom is nearing closer and closer to death. And if sure enough, it's still asleep. And I decide to go for a little search just to see what my last couple of cards are, I believe. I could be wrong. I'm like kind of checking the decks and making sure that I have enough cards. You know, I mean, to me at this point, I thought I was honestly going to get owned. But anyway, finally, my Zekrom wakes up. Not that it matters at this point, but I am going to retreat and go into, I believe it was my Hydreigon. You know, I've got enough kind of damage on my Zekrom to save it for later. And I tell you now, that does actually help. But Berserker Blade, it's going to do an absolute load to several of his Pokemon. And I'm going to start drawing prize cards like crazy. Which is, of course, good for me, but a tad bit bad for him. I don't get the Hydreigon that's prized, I only get a Dino, yeah. But all I can really do is, if I have, I don't know, if I put Clefairy in play, I can add some more cards into my hand, but that's about it. Unfortunately, Meganium is actually able to do quite a bit of damage to my Hydreigon, and I can't really do a great deal to it. Which, again, bit of a pain, but I can get some of the cards down, and like get some of my prize cards going down. As I said, Sleep Powder, he's going to put me to sleep. Pain in the rear. And something else I believe I remember is his Grottle also has Sleep Powder, which meant that, you know, I had to end this quick, because I can't rest being put to sleep all the time. So all I can really do is do more damage to each of his Pokemon. And, you know, try and KO them ASAP. It's not going to be as easy as that, unfortunately. And I do get that second Hydreigon, which is good. But, as I said, like, if you've ever been up against a deck where you are just constantly put to sleep, you find it increasingly difficult, especially when luck isn't really on your side, to like keep up a kind of pressure on your opponent, because of course you can't attack, and if you can't attack you're a bit screwed basically, but for want of a better word. But anyway, I'm straying a little bit from the point. He's going to equip another energy, which means that if necessary he can attack with Giga Bloom, I believe it was, which is going to do more damage than the Sleep Powder is doing right now. And it's only if my Hydreigon will stay asleep, even. Which does unfortunately happen in a couple of turns. Not after I've got a couple more prize cards, mind. But, that's a little bit beside the point. Anyway, my active Pokemon gonna wake up. So, luck is with me at the moment. But unfortunately, all I can do is really damage a couple more of his Pokemon. I believe it's his Chikorita and... No, it's a Bayleaf now, isn't it? No, it's his Chikorita and... Seedra. And I just realised something. Yeah, I just realised that it woke up at the end of my turn. Which is bad for me. Because he's just going to be able to put me to sleep. In fact, I think... I'm not sure, I can't tell how many, like whether that's 2 red coins or a red and a yellow. It would be better if Camtasia would let me narrate on full screen, but no, I can't tell, but I was going to say he might be able to KO me with a Giga Bloom, which does 60 damage, but no, not quite. He can from this range, but as I said, you know, Hydreigon's going to stay asleep, and I'm thinking, no, my Hydreigon, you're going to get KO'd, and I really don't want that, and then he evolves his Totodile into Croconaw, which means it's going to be even more annoying to KO, and everything's just shit hitting the fan, you know. Like, this match at the moment, it's not looking good for me. He only has, what, I know he only has four prize cards, but that's beside the point. I have an Emboar with, I don't know, three energies, is it? Three or four energies. And then everything else has no energies bar the Hydreigon that is currently in play. Now, you see, I don't know why he went for a sleep powder there. I don't know whether it was because he wanted to give me a chance or he was just kind of stalling. But as I said, Hydreigon still asleep and I can't do anything. So Hydreigon isn't actually going to wake up. And that's kind of sad. However, I can just kind of wait until he gets a extra KO. And all I can really do after that is just send in my Emboar. And of course, Emboar will be able to quite easily KO his Meganium, but that's about all it's going to be able to do. Because not only does he have several water Pokemon on the field, he also has a, I believe that's a Grottle over there, that he hasn't quite evolved yet. Thank God. Otherwise, I would be screwed. Anyway, I'm going to go for a revive. Not entirely sure why I did, because, you know, at this point, I can't really do anything. You know, I've got no energies to equip to it. And I am going to go for a Heat Crash. And, of course, that's going to be able to KO the Meganium quite easily. Does 160 damage on top of the 60 that was already there. And I managed to get a prize card. However, that isn't really going to matter, because he can just send in his Croconaw. And because it's going to be able to do double damage thanks to my Emboar's weakness, it can just use its best move, which would be Big Bite, and do 50 damage, which coincidentally would be 100 damage thanks to my weakness. So I'm just going to use Professor Oak's new theory, and of course get a new hand just to try and figure out what that last Pokemon is in my deck, or last card in my deck. But I'm not going to be able to do that, and I'll just go for a Heat Crash, KO his Croconaw, and thank God I didn't pick the other prize card. Because I got a double colorless energy with that card, and that saved my ass so bad in this match. So, of course, he's got a Grottle out. It can't KO me at the moment, but he's able to evolve it into a Torterra, which is easily able to KO me, unfortunately. And, of course, thanks to that, I can just send in my Zekrom, and unbeknownst to him, I will be able to quite easily equip a double colorless energy and KO his Torterra, which has exactly 140 HP, which is exactly the amount, oddly enough, of damage that I would be doing. So good game to Alka. I hope you guys enjoyed this trading card game online match, and I actually have a couple more decks coming up for you. So do please leave a rating, you know we love it when you like it, and do subscribe. I wish to try and hit 1,000 subscribers as soon as possible. And do stay tuned for more videos, including the London 3 trailer, which I am currently working on.